Hi, today I will start the design of a test system which permits to simulate the total air temperature probe of an AirData computer. The AirData computer is on the bottom of this page here. There are three main inputs of any AirData computer. One input is the static pressure. The second input is the total pressure, which is the sum of the static pressure and the impact pressure. There is also an input here for a platinum sensor in order to measure the total air temperature. The system I will design is inside the blue area here. There will be the same input pressures. One is the static pressure and the second one is the impact pressure. It is much better to use the impact pressure instead of the total pressure because above a given altitude, the total pressure should be negative. So in that case, you need to use two vacuum pumps. So instead of using two vacuum pumps, I will use one vacuum pump for the static pressure, which will be used only for the static pressure sensor. And I will use a positive pump, that means the pressure above 1013 millibars, in order to simulate only the impact pressure. For that purpose, I will disconnect the static pressure from the impact pressure sensor. And of course, I will do the same inside the AirData computer. The impact pressure and the static pressure will be measured using two AD converters. And there is here in the middle a microcontroller. The microcontroller will compute the Mach number. Mach number depends on the ratio between the impact pressure and the static pressure. Here, this is this formula. So this formula is valid only for subsonic speed. From the static pressure, it is also possible to compute the altitude. We can see here the relation between the static pressure in the x-axis here and the altitude in feet. And there is here a fitting function, which is a polynomial of fifth degree. This function will be included in the firmware in order to compute the altitude from the static pressure. From the altitude here, it is also possible to compute the static pressure, which is on the y-axis here in degrees Celsius. So we can see that there is a linear decrease of the temperature versus altitude, and there is a minimum temperature above 36,000 feet. According to this table here, okay. So from the static temperature in Kelvin and using the Mach number, it is possible to compute the total air temperature. The total air temperature will be converted into a voltage using a digital to analog converter, and the output voltage will be fed to a module which will simulate the total air temperature probe which is connected to the AirData computer using a three wires connection. Also on that system there will be an LCD display which will permit to display the Mach number, the total and the static air temperature and other parameters. There will be a small keypad with some push buttons. The AirData computer itself will be connected to several instruments. One is the static air temperature indicator. Second one is the true air speed indicator. There will be, of course, a Mach number indicator and an altitude indicator and a vertical speed indicator. I have already some of these instruments, the vertical speed indicator, the static air temperature, and the Mach indicator. What is missing is the true air speed indicator and an altitude indicator. I have some of them, but none is compatible with Airink 565. I bought from eBay USA one altitude indicator compatible with Airink 575, but it is also compatible with Airink 565. And I bought also a true air speed indicator. I hope it will be compatible with this AirData computer. We will see. For these two sensors, I will use the sensors which are present on this AirData computer. I have described a few months ago. So this one is for the altitude, and the second one, we can see that there are two inputs, one for the static pressure and the second one for the total pressure. But as I said, I will disconnect the static pressure, which is this one, it is common between these two sensors. So I will disconnect the tube. Okay, from that inlet here. So there will be only the impact pressure here for the airspeed and the static pressure for the altitude. So this thing can communicate using an RS-232 transmit and receive lines. Okay, but there is also an analog output. So I think it will be easier to use the analog output instead of the RS-232 output here. The simulation of a resistance here is not very easy because the resistance is not very high. It varies from 250 ohms approximately to 600 ohms, something like that. So instead of using semiconductors, I will use the servo control. I built a small prototype, and this will be something like that. So there will be a DC motor with a reductor. So I bought that thing from RS components. Okay, so there will be a PCB here. And there is here a dual potentiometer, multi-turn, 1K and 1K. So one part will be used for the servo control itself and the second part of the platinum sensor. The schematics of the servo control is here. There is a differential amplifier here with a high gain. Okay, so one input will be connected to the output of the DAC. So this voltage will set the position of the shaft of the potentiometer, and the second input here is connected to the wiper of the feedback potentiometer. Okay, so there is a virtual ground, which is the mid power supply here, 2.5 volts approximately. And there is a power stage here, which permits to drive the motor. And there is also detection of the failure of the servo control. The voltage at the output of the servo amplifier is compared with two thresholds here, which are close to the virtual ground. When the system is stabilized, when the servo control works normally, this voltage should be close to the virtual ground here. Otherwise, there will be a low level, which will be indicated using a small LED on the PCB, and the signal will be fed also to the microcontroller of the main board. The potentiometer used for the sensor is here. Okay, so the potentiometer is 1K potentiometer plus or minus 3%. So there will be a resistor in series here, an accurate resistor at 0.01%. So this permits to have a minimum temperature below minus 100 degrees. And there will be a resistor in parallel to the potentiometer, 1K5 plus 100 ohms at 0.01% also. The actual value of the potentiometer will be measured, and this value will be entered in the firmware in order to set the exact resistance value according to the temperature. And this is an image of the PCB. I will receive this PCB next week normally. So there will be the main PCB here, which will be screwed here using this hole and these two metallic studs here. And I have added also the two plates for the potentiometer, okay, and the motor itself here. There is a connector here for the total air temperature resistance, and here a micromatch connector which will be connected to the main board for the control of the resistance. We can see the output stage here. The motor will be connected here. Okay, so normally these pads are in front of the pins of this potentiometer. For the pressure altitude, I bought this vacuum pump from Vevor. There is also a tank here and some accessories. The manometer, the tube. I will use this small case for the complete system. It is an Explorer case 2209. So there will be a front panel here in black anodized aluminium with white markings. Okay, I will use also this inlet which was installed in the AirData computer. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.